Yeah, I played basketball back in the day, and there was no opportunity to go to the year again because I was so good at it. I was so good at it. They even regarded me as the Hakeem Olajuwon then. Hakeem Olajuwon, because I was playing exactly how I was playing. But there was no opportunity to go abroad. But he was my king then. I can never forget his name. His name is Mr. Cooper. He came with his daughter back then. I think it was 1997 or so. He came with his daughter to scout for basketball players. We were about 33 in the scout ground that day at the Lagos State National Stadium thing. So we were 33 that came for the scouting. So at the end of the day, only four of us was picked. I was the number one choice. Because I was very, very good at basketball then. And I have a friend that we came from the same location. That was we played together too. We chose ourselves and played 2-on-2 aside, if you know what I'm saying. So at the end of the day, I was number one staff. That was our college. But after the game, you know, our African mentality. The coaches of the at the stadium then, at the Nigerian Institute of Sports Council, they came out. They said the white man never came to them to seek permission for what he was doing. So they said he should see them after the scouting. So we never knew. He collected our data. There was no mobile phone then. We were using Nigel landline. With our name and our addresses. But to my surprise, the man never showed up again. Never showed up. He didn't see him. Now that I'm speaking to you, we didn't know what happened there, what happened after, and what is going on with him now, since then, 1997 to now. We don't know whether the Nigeria coaches, the media, they gave him other choices to pick, or probably they demanded money from him. So, I don't know. You know, Nigerian mentality and African mentality. We just pray to God that God helps us with this part of the continent.